People. So it looks like we went ahead and previously showed Michael's house in real life and as well as Franklin's. But today, we're gonna go ahead and be showcasing Trevor's trailer in real life. And boy, this is gonna be awesome. Are you looking for some free PlayStation or Xbox cards? Well, all you need to go ahead and do is hit that like button on this video, subscribe to my channel, turn notifications on, and lastly, leave a comment down below. You don't want to miss out on this. Yo, what's up, people? My name is Fernando, and I hope all of you guys are having a fabulous day so far, man. Now, here we are all the way in Sandy Shore, and my God, man, this place looks like shit. But anywho, today's video, we are going to be showcasing some real-life locations in Grand Theft Auto 5 in the real world and all that cool stuff. So before we actually do that, make sure you guys don't forget to support the video by dropping that blue thumbs up. If you guys haven't heard, YouTube has recently updated the like button, and basically they're giving out this very new special feature on your YouTube account, and all you need to go ahead and do to actually unlock that special feature on your account is leave a like on the video. And if this video manages to get over 10,000 blue thumbs up, then every single person who did leave a like will go ahead and automatically get it. Like, it'll literally pop up in your screen and you'll know you'll get it because you get notified. So don't forget to go ahead and do that. And as well, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you're new. We'll really hate it if you missed out any of my brand new videos. But with that being said, let's get on started. So for the few of you guys who actually didn't know this, the whole map of Grand Theft Auto 5 is actually inspired from California. So that's why some famous landmarks in the game itself is actually very, very similar looking to some of the places in Cali, which kind of makes sense. But right here, we're going to be talking about Sandy Shore. Now, the real life name of this place right here is actually called Palm Bay Beach. It's very, very far away from Los Angeles, and this place is currently known as a ghost town. Why exactly? Well, because it's very, very far away from the city. If you guys can tell, if you go all the way down there, there's the Los Angeles buildings and cities and all that stuff. So why the fuck would someone want to actually live here when it's very far away from civilization? Which, you know, some people don't actually have a problem with that. But another fact is the reason why people don't live here is because the water here is very, very polluted. Now, the reasons for that is the fact that a bunch of people like to go ahead and dump garbage and a bunch of other very nasty stuff inside the water, and that basically explains why this place actually smells very, very bad. You guys can kind of see it right here with all the garbage that's placed right here in the shore, and in real life, this place actually looks 10 times much more worse than in Grand Theft Auto 5. So yeah, if you actually come here, the first thing that you'll notice is the very, very bad smell and all that nasty stuff. But how about we go ahead and transfer over towards the real life version to see exactly how this matches up with the GTA 5 version. Whoa, how did we get so freaking high up? So today we're gonna be using Google Maps in order for me to go ahead and showcase Palm Bay Beach to you guys. And unfortunately, I couldn't go ahead and get a plane ticket to come here because Why would I come here? It's very, very disgusting looking. You guys are going to see exactly what I mean in a couple of seconds. So as we zoom in closer and closer, the very first thing that you guys will notice is the big old sea or lake in Grand Theft Auto 5 that's all filled with polluted garbage and all that type of stuff. And my God, this thing is absolutely humongous, man. But let's go ahead and zoom in much more closer. And right here in this very, very small part of Cali, we are here in Palm Bay Beach. And look how freaking symmetrical this place looks like, man. Oh my God, look at all these freaking homes and trailer parks. Now, as we start looking around this place right here, it looks almost exactly like freaking Sandy Shore, like the desert, all the freaking trailer parks and mobile homes, all that type of stuff. But this is basically an overview of the whole location. Now, like I said earlier, this part of the water right here is very heavily polluted. Not a lot of people actually come here because of the strong, strong smell. And of course, there's a bunch of abandoned homes and all that type of stuff. So how about we go ahead and get a street view of Sandy Shore in real life? And holy crap, man, like I said before, this thing looks almost exactly like the one in Grand Theft Auto 5. Holy crap, man, like, look at this thing. Like, I would never want to actually live here. Like, all the houses here looks like absolute garbage. Like, honestly, I have no idea how exactly Trevor honestly loves living here. Like, this place looks like a freaking dump. But then again, it actually kind of matches his personality with his violent tendency and all that type of stuff. But right here, there is a bunch of abandoned places, and holy crap, man. Now, all the way right here, we got this big old map of Grand Theft Auto 5. Now, if you guys are curious about what exactly all these colorful blimps or circles are scattered around the map, well, these are actually real life images of the famous landmarks in the game itself. So, for example, if I were to go all the way, I don't know, right here, then you guys can see that this place in GTA 5 with the famous root beer cup right here, there is the real life version of it. Now, since we're already talking about Sandy Shore, we're basically gonna write here in the search box Sandy Shore, we're gonna press enter, and right here it's gonna go ahead and showcase us all the famous landmarks that I couldn't really show earlier in the video right now. So right here, if we click on this, it will go ahead and show the GTA 5 version and the real life version of how Grand Theft Auto 5 depicted it. So right here, it's pretty interesting. Like, all these famous parts right here that you guys seen a million times when you came here to visit with your friends or by yourself, here's actually all the famous stuff that Grand Theft Auto 5 actually took inspiration from and made it into like a real life version of it right here. You know, it looks very, very similar. Like, oh my freaking God, like right here, you guys can see that once we go ahead and start moving around the little cruiser, very, very quickly, you guys can see that all the stuff from GTA 5, it's right here, real life. And this looks absolutely amazing. Like, I wish I had like a freaking like a graphic mod for PC that I can make it look exactly like this. I'm still kind of shocked how Rockstar was able to go ahead and make this look almost exactly like the one from the real life version. Like, you guys are seeing the pictures right here. Like, this is absolutely wonderful, man. Holy crap. And right here, if we go all the way there, you guys can notice the little alien camp. Well, here's the real life version of it, and you guys can see that this is again very, very similar to how it looks like in Grand Theft Auto 5. And there's the big old ocean, sea, lake, whatever it's called, from the game right here, which is all dumped with a bunch of very, very bad waters that you don't want to drink. So right here, I went ahead and downloaded a Grand Theft Auto 5 graphics pack, which basically makes everything look like freaking real life, as you guys can see. But like I said earlier, as we just drive by everything right here, you get to notice that all the houses are basically emptied out. Not a lot of people actually live here, and there's so many trailer parks, so many abandoned houses, and so much garbage everywhere. And a bunch of the houses here are also, you know, almost destroyed. The places right here is not really supported by that many folks who like to come and visit here, except for making YouTube videos, of course. That also counts. And as you guys can see, the dirty water that I mentioned so many times throughout this video, like, I'm pretty sure someone got annoyed by me mentioning it so many times. But you guys can notice that the water from all the way far away from the shore is very, very foggy. You get to see like how freaking polluted the water actually looks like. Oh my God, dude, like, oh my God. I didn't really notice how freaking dirty this was, but it's very, very dirty. And there's not so many fishes that like to swim around here, as you guys can tell from the floor right there. But yeah, man, this place is absolutely disgusting. The number one thing that you don't want to do is swim in this, because you'll just end up like the fishes on the shore. Now, let's go ahead and talk about the main thing that I'm pretty sure that you guys wanted to see in this video, which is going to be Trevor's trailer. Now, I have been looking around, I have been searching, and I have been digging around all the trailer parks around here throughout the Google Maps satellite that we saw earlier. And I gotta say that it was very, very hard to actually find something that actually looks like Trevor's trailer. Now, I know that most of this stuff looks kind of like it, but it's not really. So the closest thing that I found in the same exact location where Trevor's trailer was actually placed is this thing right here. Now, I know what you're thinking. It doesn't look almost exactly like the one from GTA 5. Well, of course, guys, you need to understand that when Grand Theft Auto 5 actually makes, you know, a house or a building and they import it over over to GTA 5. They do make some modifications. Like I stated earlier, Sandy Shore actually looks a little bit more nicer compared to the one in real life, meaning that Rockstar obviously makes some changes throughout the game to make it a little bit more eye appealing. And the same thing can be said about Trevor's trailer right here. It kind of doesn't look like it, but trust me, when I went ahead and went to the same exact location, this is what I found, and this is exactly what you guys will see if you guys come here and go towards the same exact spot where Trevor's house is at. So yeah, man, it looks very, very different, I know, but this is the closest thing that we actually got. But the Franklin and Michael's house that I made a video about a long time ago, they actually look very, very similar compared to Trevor's trailer. So yeah, that's pretty much it, and I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, support the video by dropping that blue thumbs up, it'll be ever so much appreciative, and as well, subscribe to my channel if you guys are new, and I'll see you guys later. Peace out, folks.